Hey y'all, this is James, here at the Fresh Food Factory food truck, Pensacola, Florida. Tonight, I want to take a few minutes. I want to thank everybody for all the support. Sorry, my notifications were going off. I really want to take time to thank everybody for the support, the continued support that I've been receiving over the last few months. And even before that, since I started my journey here in my food truck called the Fresh Food Factory. I want to take a minute before I get into talking to anything else that I have a couple of announcements to make that locations and dates and times where you can find us. So thank you for everybody joining in. I'll say hellos here in a minute. I need to keep my mind focused on this right now because I want to make sure that if people do watch this video that I can get it to them in the first few minutes. On May 14th and May 15th, from 10:30 to 2, we will be at Central Credit Union on 9 Mile Road on May 14th and May 15th. On the night of May 14th, we're going to be pulling double duty and go into a subdivision called Nature Trail. We're going to be doing that. Then this Saturday, I'll read the comments in a minute, guys. Just keep them coming. I promise I'll read them. I'm just trying to get my schedule out there so people know where I'm going to be. This Saturday, we were contacted today, last minute, and that's okay. We're going to be doing movie night at the Moors on Avalon Boulevard in Milton. We also do their Hope Fest in October as well, but that's down the road. We're going to be there for movie night this week, and then May 21st, we're going to be on Chemukla Highway at another movie night, and that's going to be on May 21st. On June 4th, we'll be at Nature Trail doing snow cones and kettle corns. That night as the desserts, partnered up with another food truck comrade here in town. Fresh Food Factory will be doing snow cones and kettle corn. And George at Hip Pocket Deli, a great another food, Greek food truck here in town that we love to work with. June 4th is your baby's first birthday. Well, June 4th, I will be in Nature Trail doing snow cones and kettle corn. But if you would like to get some kettle corn for your baby's first birthday, hit me up that day. I'll either save you some kettle corn or make some type of arrangement to where you can come get that corn. Tomorrow, see, I should have said this at the beginning of the video. Tomorrow, we're going to be at Molly's Finds and Furniture under the Pace Water Tower on Highway 90 in Pace from 11 to 2. Thursday, stay tuned to be announced. Friday, stay tuned to be announced. What else was I going to say? This is what anxiety is like, you know. Thank you for tuning in, everybody. I'll go through, say what up to everybody. Bella, Valerie, Chris, Ronnie, Richard, your 21st birthday. You want to order, okay. Paris, Kentucky loves watching. Thank you, Richard. I appreciate it. What state and town? I'm in Pensacola, Florida. Thank you, Miss Angela. I appreciate you. I appreciate all the support. Listen, the support that I've been getting, you know, I've been hard at work for a year. This is what? We're in May, so February, March, April, May. I've been at my own food truck 15 months, and it's been a hell of a journey. You know, the good, the bad, the ugly, the happy, the sad, the good days, the bad days. You know, it's the life of a food trucker. It's what you sign up to do. You got to stay committed to it, to no matter what. And I've been grinding at it, and I appreciate everybody, the support here in on my live streams. Thank you. I really want to take time to engage with everybody. I know I don't get to a whole lot if I'm busy and whatnot, and I appreciate it. Actually, also, what's going through my mind a lot really, to be honest with you, this is kind of what, like, anxiety, excitement, and the thrill of the game, and the thrill of the hustle and the bustle, and doing what you do, and you love what you do. You know, when you come to a food truck, I just really want to take time to also explain to people, listen, some trucks can get you your meal within a couple of minutes, depending on what type of food they do, okay? And certain trucks, depending on how many orders and how many people and what kind of really burger thing or chicken thing you do, just realize that us food truckers are really working hard, diligent, and as fast as we possibly can to keep the quality and the consistency of the product that we're providing for you, the guest and the supporter. So it's not like that we, hey, what up OG Entertainment, it's not like that we have 5 million presses in here, we don't have a 55-foot long restaurant like a lot of places. So I also take time to appreciate, to let you know that I appreciate that, you know, it does take a little bit of time with quality and freshness. You know, sometimes times could be quick, but also please be patient. If you are in line and maybe 2, 3, 4 people are ahead of you, please also take into consideration that what they order could also take up time on the grill. If one person orders 4 or 5 items, the next person, we try to get that line moving as fast as possible, especially me. I am a solo employee. I look to hopefully one day maybe have a solid assistant, co-worker, staff member, team member, and go from there. But I got to also be out there on the daily grind, grinding it out by myself to be able to make that money to get the growth and stuff like that. To be able to have, and here's also a hard problem with some of us food truckers, is finding a person that can work some of these odd shifts, you know, like the nighttime shift at the nature trail, and a double up on one day. You know, quality and passion comes before quantity and money, okay? You know, there you go, good point, Eric, physics. You put cold stuff on a grill and stuff like that, but we're not here to talk about that. I also want to make another big announcement. Starting May 11th, is going to be the www.vippensacola.com voting. I've been nominated by everybody here. Thank you also everybody that nominated the Fresh Food Factory in 2 divisions in vippensacola.com. We got nominated to be in the category for Best Food Truck. We also got nominated to be into the best category for best burger. And this is a big staple here in town. Oh my God, I'm going to sneeze. Please do not sneeze right now in front of this video. I got to sneeze. Oh my gosh. Excuse me, what? I didn't touch anything, as you barely hear it. That was kind of like out of nowhere. Let me wash my hands so you guys know everything is A-okay. Give me a second. Boy, that came out of nowhere. That really came out of nowhere. I guess I would have to consider that part of the bloopers. I guess I could consider that part of the blooper when I go on this this 10-city tour that we're going to be taking. I'm doing a 10-city tour in the state of Florida. From mile marker 0, right at the Alabama line, all the way down to the Keys. So I'm doing a self-documented movie tour. Thank you, Miss Angela. Hey, all it does is take pride and passion in what you do. Your kitchen will always stay clean. But starting on May 11th, see, don't get me sidetracked. Starting on May 11th, I will be putting up the link and everything like that, that to where you can go and vote at vippensacola.com and get us, get me, get the food truck called the Fresh Food Factory here in Pensacola, Florida, to get to that staple. It is truly a staple to be able to be nominated for two categories. It would be even bigger to at least take one of the two. The goal is one of the two, if not two. And thank you for everybody that supported me by getting me nominated at VIPPensacola.com. Voting's going to start May 11th. I got to find out the start day and the stop day. What up, Chris Gray? Best rock man in Pensacola. If y'all don't know, that's the man to get the granite, marble, quartz, polished, touched up, finished up, start to begin, everything. Got a showroom that'll knock your socks off. Rocks from around the world. You want a countertop from Brazil? Guaranteed, Chris Gray got it. Stand behind that work, 100% satisfaction guaranteed. Hit up Chris Gray at Gray's Granite. Anyways, so I'm also getting a grocery list. And also kind of what's got my anxiety up and going is I'm also working on trying to get contacts. And everybody knows, I've been saying since I started to want to do this film documentary thing that our number one sponsor, Michael Swanson, thank you, sir, I'm going to make you proud with this DVD documentary and my little tour here in the state of Florida. I'm going to make you proud to be able to say that you're the one that got me getting me going with the GoPro 8, memory cards, batteries, tripod, selfie stick. I appreciate you very much. You're going to get my journey started. And because of you, you're the number one sponsor of my live documentary. Everything, I really appreciate all the support. But I will be looking out to the some of the companies where we use the sauces, where I use their ingredients and stuff like that to help along the way. You see what I'm saying? Trying to help get the sponsorship out there. So if anybody would like to throw in on a sponsorship, you can hit me up at freshfoodfactory2019@gmail.com. It is going to take a lot, and I'm going to do this. I'm actually working to fund my own trip. I'm not looking for people to... I'm not... You know what I'm saying? How do I say this? It's really going to be on a professional level. Look, I'm just not doing a cell phone live all the time. We're really going to do a nice, good documentary. We're going to release the YouTube series for like 4 to 6 weeks, one or two episodes a week. All the behind-the-scenes bloopers. We're going to put it on a downloadable CD, DVD. I'm going to do it. But I want to thank Big Mike. And I appreciate y'all saying that I got your vote. I appreciate it. I am working to fund my own trip. This is not a handout call. If you are a business and or somebody that would like to sponsor, somehow along the way, we can talk. You know, we'll just say that. I really don't know how. See, I don't have a PR person, so I don't know how that PR person would approach other people by saying, hey, you know, we're reaching out to you. I just really know how to be a real person. I can do business. I'm just not on that business side. I don't have the connections to call the people and stuff like that. I'm not a big broadcaster where I get millions and millions of views. I don't have a network behind me funding this. I am actually working to fund this on my own. Each city I stop is what's going to dictate my journey through in the state of Florida. If I go to Jacksonville and I bust out and make $150, well, it's $150. I got to get to the next, even maybe small city, and hustle up. I'm doing my own thing. So I appreciate all the positive things. I'm mapping things out. My ideas. Listen, with somebody that's got bipolar, anxiety, PTSD, this is what anxiety looks like. When you know, you're trying to focus on something, you're trying to plan. Believe me, I'm trying to dot my T's, cross my I's. I'm the producer, the editor, the filmmaker, the worker, the grunt, the go-getter, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm trying to work out maybe some different packages on sponsorships. I don't know how that stuff works either. I'm not looking to make a dollar off anybody trying to help, maybe want to sponsor, throw in the tip jar, or anything like that. Trust me, that's not, I'm going to earn my own way by working stop to stop to stop to stop to stop. That's part of the grind and hustle that I want to show people, that people like us, what we really do. What up, Sarasota? I'm coming to Sarasota, Chris. I'm going to be down there. What up, TJ? Christopher? Shout out to Canada. I appreciate you. Yep, I'm getting my... We got the Bacon King up in the house, Mr. TJ and his... Hey, TJ, check this out, dude. What about a bacon? Listen to me now. Take bacon and you weave it out into like a little round tortilla shell. Make the taco shell out of it. Line it with some pineapple and some chicken. Maybe a little bit of rice and teriyaki sauce. Choo-choo-choo. Got that bacon Hawaiian teriyaki chicken taco. What? Anyways, I'm planning my tour. I don't know how to do this. I'm doing the best I can. This is what somebody that has anxiety, you know, can sit here and I'll probably go to bed at midnight and wake up at 3. Come back in the truck and prep for the day. You know what I mean? Damn, make that happen. Logan. See, that's what... Just saying sponsorships from the food truck. Truck calling, say, sponsorship lasts 3 days. They'll spin it in the air, can hang like... You know, Chad, I'd like to try to do something like that. I mean, I'm not going to... I'm not going to sugarcoat it. I'm one person. I really don't, I wish I had a PR social media, helper. My friend Destin, she does what she can. You know, everybody does work and, you know, I'm not an expert at it. So, you know what I'm saying? So, I do know anybody that, even all the way down to my tip jar, anybody that's, everybody since I started my tip jar. Let me tell you some of the... I'm not going to put names out there. You know who you are here. Let me point up there. You know who you are. Appreciate the help through my tip jar. It's actually helped me give other meals away. I'm not looking for clout. I'm just saying it's helped me cook some food and meals for the homeless and nurses and the police department and stuff like that. And a couple weeks ago, we gave a free meal away because of one of my supporters here said the next person that comes up gets it. And it was the fire department. And a young man, he got a free meal. So, you know, everybody that has gone to my tip jar, I will be messaging you through my tip jar to let you know, or even get permission that we put your name and picture in the credits of my documentary. If you don't want to, hey, that's cool. We can make you up a funny name with your donation to help get us going. We won't put the amount of the donation. That's nobody's business toward anything like that. But anybody that put anything in my tip jar to help stuff like that, listen, that's really helped. You know what I mean? I'm not even going to lie. Some of the money I got through the tip jar, I went and bought a mount to be able to hang the phone up there. And I got a new charger to where I don't have to run the cord all the way over and around and tuck it in behind the thing. I can run it to my cigarette lighter plug-in thing. So I got a cord there. We bought that. Unfortunately, several long time of months ago, that my square pad that I keep my iPad in, the disc thing to read the chips, it got wet, my stand broke, but I've been working with it and not complaining. The tip jar is actually, hopefully by the end of this week or maybe sometime next week, is going to get me a whole new square stand and everything like that, so when I am on the road doing this documentary, we could do things and stuff like that. Believe me, listen, I am earning my way. I told you guys I'm doing snow cones and kettle corn to fund the documentary, and that's what we're doing. I'm just still out on the daily grind, And anybody that does any type of donation through the tip jar, you will get a credit in our documentary at the end of it. Drinking a Molson Canadian beer. That's a little strong for me. I'm not even going to lie. I'm a Budweiser Bud Light guy. And then a shot of Crown Apple with a couple ice cubes in it. That's me. If and when I do drink. I'm really not a big drinker. But, you know, I'm trying to get like a map, you know, map it out feasibly. Working on the way down and then working on the way up. I need to start trying to, you know, I work during the day when other places are working. When I get done, I'm still working because I have to clean to keep it upright and everything. So I don't get a chance to call and say, hey, you know, I'm trying to reach out to people and work. Or, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to, Chad, that I am. Call the tour Florida food trucking. Well, I could call the tour whatever, but it's the name of the documentary and the name of the series and stuff. Listen, I really want this to go as, I want this to be professional as I can do this, man. I know I can do this. What's up, Michael? I know I can do this. I'm going to make it as professional as I can. Who needs a network? I'm an independent person. So, you know, we're going out on a daily grind. We're doing it. I will be doing this. What up, Ryan? I will be contacting the seasoning companies that I use to season my meats. And I'm going to try to reach out to them via email. I don't know how to word it. See, I wish I would have been more languageable instead of redneck languageable. When you're emailing a company asking for sponsorship or product or like that for whatever you're doing, I do know this. You just can't go at it redneck style. You need somebody that knows what they're saying, knows how to put it in like sentence form, so when they look at it, they go, oh wow, this really looks professional, yada, 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 okay. Hey, we'd like to hop on board and send this guy a case of our burger seasoning. Or, I'm going to film everything. Listen, Ryan, I'm actually going to reach out. I know there's a guy here in town. What up, Matt? I know there's a guy here in town that comes and supports us. He gets food. He has a computer company. I'm going to reach out to him. No, I didn't sell out. I had a slow day today, Michael. But that's okay. I'm still here to talk about it. It didn't kick my butt. Well, things are starting to reopen around here, and I support other places too, and a lot of other people have been out of work for a while, and during that time, I was able to pick up and keep going just a little bit. I do think that now that things are open, I need to travel back around to my locations. I was Ontario, what up, Canada? Chad, I kind of thought about mentioning that, but I also don't, you know, I got a lot of videos that's got cuss words in it. I got a lot of videos that, you know, maybe accidentally calling something out or being an asshole or a jerk, or maybe they don't like me too much cussing or anything like that. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's okay, Michael. I'm not saying I planned for it, but I got some really good locations that we're going to be going to here pretty soon. I got a nature trail, I got a movie night this weekend, I got a movie night in the weekend after that, I got Pace tomorrow, I don't forget about Pace. We are on a weekly schedule at Pace, Jonathan, every single Wednesday, sir. I know it is, Chad, I know that's me, but some people don't like that rough around the edges, like, whoa. You know, you're just a little too much. And you're really not as good as you think you are. But, you know, John, I wish I could, but unfortunately, I think they already have somebody out there. What up, Knoxville? What up, Tyler Lee? Appreciate you. Tommy, yes, ma'am, I will be in Pace tomorrow. Put on an Elvis costume. The only costume I got is ugly and fugly. That's what I got. I got ugly and fugly. Appreciate you, Insight. Yeah, I'm trying to map down, you know, also kind of what I thought about a little bit ago. And what up, Michael? Michael, you'll have to rewatch this video. You'll have to watch the first 10 minutes. Ryan, I know that, but this ain't real. This ain't drama. It's actually, I mean, it's drama, but this is real life. You know, this is real life shit, dude. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing okay, Mr. Anthony. How about you? Yes, sir, Mr. Steve. I'm trying to write down ideas for my tour, my little documentary, things that. About to look for that movie, Chef. Look, dude, I'm telling you, watch that movie, Chef. If my son wasn't leaving to go see his great-great-grammy for vacation, I know I didn't shave my head tonight, Greg. I might do it in the morning, but I probably won't. I'm trying. Hey, Gerald, you know what my number one goal is out of this little tour and documentary thing that I'm wanting to do? You know what my end goal on that is? Not even gonna lie, dude. I've been trying to get oral surgery for my mouth for a long time now. But now I faced the Reaper and I went to the dentist. I was finally able to work each day on my grind, because I've documented that growth here too, is I was finally able to get a new set of dentures for the top that actually somewhat fit real good. My bottom ones, I need more oral surgery than an oral surgeon can have. So, while my wife and kids are on vacation seeing grandma, great-grandma, and great-great-grandma and stuff, I thought about doing this. It's like, because all the events are canceled, where I planned on trying to get to these events to try to get that better dollar to get the $5,000 that it's going to take to have the oral surgery that I need, okay? My goal is to do that in 10 days. But I also still have home front stuff to do. So this is the journey. I'm taking a lot of my Facebook videos here. We'll figure it out somehow. I'll get videos off of here to put them in the documentary. I'm trying to grind. I'm trying to get it out there. And man, this is the real deal, man. I'm doing it. You know, my goal on this little Florida tour, since a lot of things were canceled, is I got in my own head. I'll create my own thing. You know what I mean? I'll create my own thing. Yeah, if you want to call it a reality food truck TV show. Yeah, Ryan, that kind of really is the goal, bro. I'm not going to lie. What's my end game besides keeping my food truck and never quitting because this is what I love to do? Yeah, why not? Why not reach for that? The reality food truck TV show, go on tour. You know what I mean? I can do that. I'm going to start it with me. I don't need, well, you know what I'm saying. I'm going to be the one that's doing what I want to do. Not what I really want to do, but you know what I mean? I got goals, man. That movie, Chef, listen, man, you don't understand. Ever since I've been in my food truck and I actually really watched that movie, listen, man, that put a light under my booty so dang hard that I really can't. Listen, it goes through my mind probably at warp speed times 10. And look how, by time I get done, by time next week, this little notepad's going to be filled. Yes, it is, Michael. You have to look up the movie. You have to look up the movie. I'm going to have to rewatch it too, bro. Look, I need to rewatch it so I find the spot that food truck got to sit up in Miami. I would love for my, I want to find out what bar, what club, what section, where he went when they filmed that movie Chef. He was set up in Miami somewhere. I want to visit and try to set up in that same spot and film my own little thing as well. Right, Mr. Mark? Stuart? Yes, it is, Evan. Anthony, do you live down there, bro? That's right, it was in Little Havana. Hold on, let me write that down. I was going to rewatch the movie. Bro, I'll probably rewatch that movie 15 more times. I'm actually going to show. I'm a get a Twitter page tonight. Little Havana, that's right. Little Havana. Man, that movie's awesome, bro. Eric, man, listen. I seen that movie late last year, and I've been live streaming my truck for a year. And I'm not saying I'm Mr. Original, okay? People take videos and do things and stuff like that. I've got a couple of mentors that I follow here on Facebook, and I really watch and ask questions in the side key. I watch a lot of other people. I learn things and stuff like that. And there's been a few people that I followed that inspired me on here. And then last year when I seen that movie, I was like, man, I live stream. I'm the only one that really keeps it like raw and like Andrew Dice Clay. It's raw and uncut. I'm not meant for TV. I'm not trying to be on TV. Because if I was ever on TV, the only thing you would hear is beep, 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 beep. It would be like in Morse code. They would have to put type up on the movie. Oh, and that's the other thing. Hold on. When doing documentary, movie, have subtitles. Dang, that's going to be a lot of work right there. When doing documentary, movie, have subtitles for hearing impaired. That's number one on my list right there. Because I have an aunt that's deaf. I'm trying to, Chris. I just don't know how to approach people without just being real. You know what I mean? Plus, I got to get in touch with different cities to find out. I need to get in touch with other food truckers in the area. I need to get in touch with other food truckers in the area to network or see kind of what the hotspots are. Get into places and stuff like that. Appreciate you, Evan. Thanks for all your support, man. William, Patrick, Gerald, I'll always be myself. I know this is something that I could, you know, we got Chi-Town in the house, Little Havana between Coral Gables and Brick Hill. Coral Gables. Yeah, but I see what you mean, and I know you'll tell me, raise the bar, have a sign language person interpreter in the corner, bro. Matt, sign language interpreter in corner. Dude, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. I'm sorry I might have missed some comments. Bro, that's brilliant. Thank you for that. I'll make that happen, because I got deaf family. I do. And hold on. I think I actually got some supporters that follow me that are deaf. I think I got some supporters and followers that follow me that are deaf. You should see how you can go about setting up and stream with the stars. They are donation points, and you can help me. Steven, I need a PR person. I need a PR person. I don't know people like that, man. I'm just a redneck in a truck trying to do his thing, live a dream, make a dollar, raise my wife and kids, and start my own thing, man. Maybe this is what needs to be out there. A real reality show. Not none of that behind the scene. And this is me, raw and uncut. I'm like Andrew Dice Clay. You know what I mean? And it's my own documentary. You know? Stay with me next year. We might go across a few states next year. Goals, dreams, passion, ambition. I appreciate you, Matt. I'm just trying, bro. Look, you need a signature move? What do you mean a signature move? Here, I'm going to gloat about this one. You know what my signature move is? You want to know what my signature move is? I'm the only one with it, and I designed it. And this is also a tour to show people my jackets. You want to know what my signature move is? Ooh, I don't cross-contaminate. Oh, I don't have to touch a kitchen towel to wipe off that sweat off my forehead. Oh, with the removable patches. I never touch a kitchen towel. That's my signature move. Oh. The perfect working shirt for any kitchen staff member, from chef to sous chef to fry cook to broiler to steam to bake to oven to prep to server to bartender to expo to hostess to everybody in the hospitality industry. My shirt is a game changer. That's my move. Boom. Boom. You'll never touch a kitchen towel in this truck. That's my signature move. I dab while I cook. Right, Evan? Bam! Bam! There it is. But, you know, there's a lot running through my head. Trying to get things together to try to hopefully... Like I said, I'm going to film this whole thing. I'm going to do a thing with bloopers. There's going to be edits. You're going to get on the DVD that I'm going to try to make. Is it called The Chef Show? No, Mr. Michael. You actually have to go into movies. And it's a movie called Chef. Anthony Carson. I applied for the license. Also, that's also why I want to do this little tour. Because I think I can take all the portion and proceeds from this little tour after I get my mouth fixed, with whatever I have left over there, to mass produce my shirts and apply for an investor that can take me out to the world with it. By doing this documentary, I can show my product along the way, because that's going to be one of the biggest sponsors, is my shirt. Okay? Hamza says, I'm a server in the UK. Wait till I get him fully out there, brother. Okay, Steven, as far as I know with the Google stars and what you're talking about right there, from what I understand, you have to have 10,000 likes and 10,000 followers. Anthony, yes. But see, when you go to that, you have to have sales. You have to have proprietary things and stuff like that. Because the first thing they're going to ask you is, what was your sales? How well did the product, you know? I'm just a little bitty. I'm not even the the ant on top of the molehill yet. I'm still at the bottom digging a hole trying to get going. Hello, Darlene. Appreciate it, Austin. Spliff it up, homie. Yes. Or they want, they with even without numbers, you have to prove that whatever you have can be patentable, licensable, and proprietary. Proprietary. Not saying that you can't go in without a product with no numbers, but that's my goal. I'm also wanting to get my shirts out. Yes, it's, this whole tour thing is really gonna set my life into a different direction for me and my family. Hold on, let me see something real quick. I was like, man, did I put that thing over there? Anyways, and that's gonna help me. Invite Steve-O. Steve-O's in California. But I do know this. If I do hit the Fort Lauderdale, Port St. Lucie, Stewart area, Vanilla Ice, you're welcome to the truck, bro. Vanilla Ice, come on by and get that Ice Baby Burger. We got you covered. Fresh Food Factory food truck. Vanilla Ice, come on by and get you a fat-ass burger from a food truck. I appreciate you, Anthony. Hey, you know what? It's gonna happen, man. Listen, y'all just Facebook sponsored ad. Hey, I'm trying to do this all on my own. Yeah, but I see what you mean, Jordan, is get Facebook sponsored ads on your videos. Yeah, he lives in Port St. Lucie. Yeah, like Port St. Lucie Stewart. Yeah. Grand Rapids in the house. Appreciate it. Thank you for tuning in. Yay, Gerald, go take care of your phone battery, man. You have a good night. Thanks for tuning in. Also, if you guys don't already follow my YouTube channel, you have to follow my YouTube channel to actually get... That's where I'm going to release this series. When I record, when I get home after all of my recording, you're going to get the series on Facebook. And then we're going to have the DVD download, YouTube live, Facebook live, Instagram live party when I do the DVD release. You know what I mean? But now I'm going to tighten up the truck and take my notepad with me, because actually there's a Facebooker I want to do a collaboration with. There's a Facebook down south, and I think he is in Miami. I'm going to try to get in touch with him and see if we could do some type of Facebook collaboration down there when I'm there. You know, try to get in touch with him. You know, see, and here's the thing about not having what's going to make it hard for me is I don't have that so-called publicist, and we're not a known thing and stuff like that. So you actually got to find different places that'll, what's my favorite item on, I don't even eat my own food, dude. Dustin. All the stuff, listen, all the stuff on my menu, that it's all great, man. You know why? Because it's just great. But you have to follow my YouTube page called Fresh Food Factory. That's the only place that you're going to be able to see any of this journey. The only part you'll see here on Facebook is when I go live and I'm actually cooking during that. But to get all the other stuff, the everything that I'm doing behind the scenes, on the scenes, closing down, to shopping, to cleaning, to the whole thing, you're going to have to look on YouTube for that. So make sure you follow my YouTube channel, Fresh Food Factory. starting on Monday, I'll be releasing a couple videos a week on YouTube and places that we're going. That's the only place you're going to be able to find it is actually on YouTube. Why don't I read your message? Probably because I didn't see it, Hazma. But I seen that one. And what is the question before I end my video? But yeah, I got tons of notes. So. And I also got a plan for tomorrow. I actually might make some simple syrup and maybe do lemonade. I gotta watch the weather. He wants a job. Where are you at? Hazma? Appreciate it, Dustin. Greg, that's just... I did okay today. Okay, you're a waiter. I can work with you. Where are you a waiter? Where are you a waiter at? You're in Morocco. Okay. I'm in Pensacola, Florida, young man. So how can I hire you all the way from Morocco? Hey, I would love for you to come over from Morocco. Okay? Maybe we could work out a work visa next year. Apply for it. What up, Michael? Why don't you apply for a work visa to the Fresh Food Factory food truck, and we'll get you from Morocco. You get a work visa, you can come here and work with me. How about that? We'll bring you in from Morocco. Hey, Victoria, you like that, don't ya? Look at that right there, that pretty old jar. And my redneck pension. Uh-oh. Attention, everybody. Attention, everybody. Christy Whitaker is in the building. Y'all gotta stop and slow down. Recognize Christy's in the building. Pedro. Oh. Hey, you know what? Hold on. Hey, Ryan, hold on. Isn't that the guy? I'm writing that down. Hold on. Isn't he the guy that looks white, that speaks Spanish on the food truck? That would be awesome to connect with that dude. Is that him? I think I follow him, or I've seen some of his, like, videos or his little skits where people don't know he knows Spanish, and he does those videos and montages about his food truck and being Mexican and doing this and that. Isn't that him or no? Christy says, hey, Pensacola knows me. Yes, that dude is funny as... I don't know why I don't see any more of his videos. Maybe I gotta refollow him, because you know how Facebook is. If you don't always... listen, y'all. Y'all make sure people... I get notifications all the time. Hey, did you post? Listen, I post every day where we're gonna go. You might have to scroll down, because Facebook, you know, if you don't interact with pages, it'll do an unfollow. You have to refollow, and then you got to see first. You know, you want to stay up with us in the Fresh Food Factory, make sure you see first. But also make sure... Okay, Hazma. You know, I can't apply for your work visa. You would have to do all that on your end, sir. I don't know anything about that. But yes, Pedro, I'm going to make his ass light on fire. You want fire, Ese? Ese, you want fire? Give him fire, Pedro. Yeah, stuff like that. He is funny, man. I can't imitate him. He's one of a kind original dude. That would be awesome to meet up with him. That would be yeah, he's funny as shit, man. Is he down in Miami or anything like that? South Florida? Caliente! No, down there, it's down when you're in Miami, it's Fuego. En Fuego. I'm gonna have to brush up on my Spanish. I'm gonna have to brush up on my Spanish and get a little busy. Anyways, the anticipation for tomorrow. This is what it's like when somebody has anxiety and can't go to sleep. And they want to do things, and your mind's do. How old am I? I'm 48, dude. Hamza, I can't call Morocco. I don't have an international line. And I just don't give my phone number out to anybody. Don't you? Do you know who I'm getting ready to be? I'm getting ready to be famous and be somebody. I just can't give out my phone number to anybody. I hope you understand that. No, I'm joking. Oh, James, you're an asshole. See, that would be good footage. Listen, that would be good footage if that GoPro was sitting right here. Filming me and filming this at the same time, that would have been good footage right there. Christy. Oh, I got your number too. Some around your age, I like Vanilla Ice. He was okay. You too. Hey, Corey, I appreciate it. He was okay. I liked a couple of his songs. He was okay. You know. It was okay. And we all say that, and guess what? When that song comes on in a club, everybody's singing that mother flutter. When that song comes on in a club, everybody's singing it. So I guess you can't hate on it. Hamza says, so wait, what is the way to get to you? The way to get to me, you would have to apply for a work visa. And then you can apply for a work visa, and you could just tell them that you would like to come to America and work on a food truck called the Fresh Food Factory. I'm sure they'll look up all that information and go from there. Yeah, everybody in the club. Where about you located down in Florida in the next couple of months? Corey, next month I'm going on tour filming a movie. What up, Gabriel? Appreciate you, Sally. How? My birthday is October 9th. I know, right? Andrew, hey, you know what? Outtake footage. Hold on. See, that's another thing. Hold on, right there. Hold on. I'm going to write that down. Hold on. Outtake footage on Facebook Live. About Morocco work visa. What's today's date? Today's Cinco de Mayo, May 5th, 2020, Facebook live. Okay, I got me a notation down. We'll have to use that as one of the outtakes on the documentary. How we trying to get somebody from Morocco over here to come and work. You just have them look, hey, Hamza, when you go apply for your work visa, you just tell them to look me up on Facebook. Tell them, see, this is who I want to go and work for right here. Look at the video. Here's his information. This is who I want to go work for. And we'll make that happen. You get approved work visa, I'll put you to work. What up, Amanda? Hey, what up, Amanda? What am I doing? At the beginning of the video, I was actually letting people know my schedule for the next couple of weeks. Places that, you know, we're going tomorrow, I'm going to Pace. 14th and 15th will be at Central Credit Union. May 14th at nighttime, private feeding and nature trail. This Saturday, we're going to be at the Moores on Avalon Boulevard in Milton for movie night. We'll also be doing movie night on Chemukla Highway on May 21st. June 4th, I'll be doing snow cones and kettle corn back out at Nature Trail. So, and I also talked about a few other things. Don't tell me you just woke up from today. I know, right, Andrew? So, I need to get in touch with some of these seasoning places that I use and ask them if they would like to help out on sponsorships for what I'm trying to do. I guess I'll Google it. I'll go to what? Google Language Professor? Right? I'll Google Language Professor. Hey, this is what I want to say. Can you put it in professional terms? You need some ranch fries. I don't have no ranch. Hopefully I get some fries in the morning. Well, Hamza, my phone number, all my contact information is on my website, freshfoodfactory.net. Yeah, I guess I'll Google Language Professor and tell them what I want to say redneck and see how they put it in professional form when you're looking for sponsors or anything like that. No, I won't be doing fried pickles. I do sometimes. I make my own fried pickles. I can make them. So I got a grocery list for tomorrow. You got our dates and locations because I need that. I need this. I'm like an old man. I carry a notepad. Write down things. You know what I mean? Need some cheesesteak tots. Actually, those don't happen. She got lucky today. But the cheesesteak, I'll tell you, you want to know what game changer with the tots are? Listen. Yeah, Sally, it is. Sally, it is. It really is. That's when people like us use our street culinary degree. I don't know. What month do you want to apply for it? Mark, shush. I'm going to have to delete that comment. How about come from for Christmas? You want to come for Christmas in Florida from Morocco? That'd be some shit right there. I get a call from customs or something, some or another. Yes, Hamza Lukes is applying to come to America to work with you on a Fresh Food Factory food truck. What up, Lucas? Andrew. Oh, boy. I'd be like, hold on. James ain't available right now. Can I please take a message? No, it's all good, Greg. Hey, I put it out there how I do it. It's all good. But anyways, that's our schedule. Tomorrow we're in Pace. Thursday to be announced. Friday to be announced. Slap yo mama. You know, slap your mama. Listen, slap your mama works really good on pork butts and barbecue. Lucas. Lucas, you listen. As funny, listen, dude. You know, I joke around a lot, and you know, just because I have dreams on things. Dude, that really couldn't. I don't know. I mean, how do I say? I guess that could be cool, but. That's not the end game. You want to know what the end game is, really, for me, is just to make sure that I keep making the best living that I can and make my wife and kids as comfortable as I can because of all the years that we've struggled to make it for me to do this. My end game is only that. Fame can pay my bills. But it doesn't make my wife and kids happy on what their dad is doing and what their husband is doing and or his potential on what they can become. That, to me, is being fame. Fame for family. Because you got the F-A and F-A. I appreciate it, Lucas. I do. Hey, man, you know what? I tell you what, to be honest with you, I could hit the lotto tomorrow for $5 million, and guess what? All I would do is buy a house and give my kids the money and still go to work the next day. I would just be more popular. Hey, that's the guy that won $5 million on the lotto. He's still going to work. I got Tony's. I use Tony's Zatarain's on my shrimp. That's all I need, man. I'm to the point. Listen, bro. I'm 48 years old. Christy, no you won't, because then I'm moving to the country. I'm moving to the country. Gonna eat me a lot of peaches. That's right, Sally. No, Christy. See, that's the first thing I'm doing is buying a piece of property. And ain't nobody gonna know where I'm at. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. No. Yeah, hey, Greg, I actually listened to, without getting into things, I actually know about his story, too. Also, did you know this? Did you guys know that Tim the Toolman Taylor? Like, money is just a tool, gotta use it the best way possible. It is. I appreciate it, Hamza. Look, all I want to do is set my kids up for the best life that they can try to live and go from there. I'm 48 years old. My life's far from over, but theirs is just beginning. And that's the beginning and the end of my game. That's the number one goal in all. Trust me, I'd love to make that money hand over fist. But, you know, it's good. Okay, Hamza. Yeah, man, you know, I really, you know, money's nice, don't get me wrong. I'd like to go out and do things and stuff like that. But really, it, you know, I, man, you know, I got two kids. I got a 16 and a half year old, and I got an 11 year old. And, you know, I've told my story. I spent a lot of time in prison. I was sentenced under that three strikes, you're out law. I almost didn't make it out of prison. I should have been in there for the rest of my life. The greatest of all time? How? You know? So now I got two lives that I'm responsible for. So I got to try to make it the best way that I can from him. What is my favorite book? I actually got two of them, to be honest with you. One of them is The Green Mile, and the other one is the one with wrote by Tupac, A Rose That Grows from Concrete. Billy Idol. Billy Idol. I got it. Country living here 25 years. There's still some country left here in Pensacola. You know, fucking Billy Idol. Oh, God. It's a nice day for a white wedding. Anyways, what time is it? Yeah, I'll be up in 5 hours. Oh, what about the Tim the Toolman Taylor? I'm sorry. Thank you, Alyssa, for tuning in. You've been silent. Look at you, been silent. Join the conversation. Don't be scared. It's okay. We don't bite. Anyways, I also read Tim the Toolman's Taylor story. Tim the Toolman Taylor was also in prison. He was also in prison. Tim the Toolman Taylor did time in prison. The plan for tomorrow is to get up in the morning, come in here, and look at everything. And plan the day. I'm going to Pace. I'll be in Pace from 11 to 2. You have been laughing a lot. Well, I appreciate it. That makes me laugh. Dang, what time is it again? Dang, 10:14. 4 o'clock in the morning comes early. Yep, we got a GoPro 8 coming. It should be here by Sunday. Hamza, if they call me, I'm filming it. If they call me, I'm getting on a Facebook Live and I'm going to film it that we're talking to whoever we're talking to about a work visa. But yeah, Tim the Toolman Taylor went to prison, got out, did something with his life. The movie Chef. That's kind of been, man, ever since I seen that movie last year, it's been in my head. I really don't have a lot of prep to do due to the fact that I got to go buy groceries. I need to go get some green peppers. And I was prepped for Monday and Tuesday, somewhat. I'm still good on stuff because it's been slow the last 2 days. I know that would be funny, right, Alyssa? What up, Teresa? I appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, I got to text Amber. Well, I'll get fries. I'll get fries when the store opens. Somebody said something about a tattoo. What did you say about a tattoo? That would be awesome to get tattooed by somebody famous down in Miami, wouldn't it? Hint, hint. I'm going to try to see if I can set up in front of a tattoo shop and see if I can get me some ink by a famous person. No. Hashtag goals. Hashtag goals. Okay, Hamza. We look forward to you applying for your work visa to come work on a food truck from Morocco. Is that Morocco, Spain? Lucas, I usually try to prep the day of. Yeah, I don't prep for the whole week. I try to prep in 3 days, that's it, on certain things. Okay, Hamza, for my book note, send me your number. I like to cut my meat for the day. I don't freeze no meat. Yes, sir, Mr. Lucas, that's why I'm called the Fresh Food Factory. Oh, Andrew, listen, my wife, as many times as she's told me to not do it and or go for it and do it or whatever, I've never, every time I've told her something, I do it. Or when I told her I was going to sell my lawn care business and start a bounce house business, she was like, okay, but you know that if it don't pay the bills, that I only make so much, that you might have to get a job. I'm like, I know. So I was working in the restaurant industry and doing bounce houses. I had a little bounce house gig on the side. And that's what got me back in the industry again for a long time. So, okay, Hamza. So, and now here I am, sitting in a food truck at 10:15 at night because I'm trying to put my... Maria, first time viewer. Thank you for tuning in. What up, William? What up, the Lemonade Man? I already screenshotted it. It's getting late. I need to wind down. It's hard. You see, this is the part about anxiety and your PTSD. Like, when you're focusing and things on something, sometimes your adrenaline and your anxiety, it's not a bad anxiety. It's a mind anxiety. And you can't wind down. You can't sit still. There's nothing really to do. And your mind is just like this. You know what I mean? It's like 10,000 spiders going through your head when you know you want to be doing something and you could be doing something, or what is it there's to be done? And you know, that's the thing with anxiety and PTSD and bipolar that, you know, people like me deal with. Sometimes I don't sleep because my mind doesn't shut down. And when I do shut down, I don't shut down very long because my anxiety continues through the night while I'm sleeping. Yeah, Aaron, I'll get my mind right in a little bit. You know what I mean? And that does help. That's why I'm a licensed. I have a card. You know, but with... Oh, yeah, of course, Aaron. Yeah, but the mind is right, but my body's got to relax. You see what I'm saying? So we got to go into couch. We got to get that into couch going, and then it helps my body shut down. You know what I mean? And thank you, Maria, for saying food trucks have great food. Make sure you tune in to this. Lucas, it is exhausting in your head. It does. Listen, anxiety and being bipolar and PTSD like that, it's really like like it's exhausting, but it's an exhaustion that wears you down in a different way, but also at the same time it keeps me motivated to not let it beat me up all the time. So that's why, like, with this thing that I'm planning, the road trip documentary thing like this, my anxiety is not anxiety from, like, oh my God, I can't handle this. My anxiety is kind of like the excitement, the anticipation of something that I'm going to try to accomplish, but how am I going to get there and do it? Can I do it? Am I going to be able to do it? Will I get through it? How will it be? You know what I mean? Those things are going through your head, and that's what makes it. You see what I'm saying? Thank you, Maria. Right, Alyssa? See, and everybody's different, you know? Like with me right now, I'm tired, but I know if I lay down, my mind is instantly going to go to hopefully a dream like I had last night about I can make this. That OCD, believe me, I got that too. Name something with the D that I don't have. How about that? Ryan, name something with a D I don't have. PTSD. OCD. All of that. But I work through it. I don't let it kick my ass. And when it does kick my ass, that's when I know it's time for me to, you know, step back, take a break, because I'm not going to kill myself. You know, but I try not to get those. And sometimes when you do get those, man, it's sometimes it's uncontrollable. You just don't want to. Yeah, it's scrambling in your mind. You know what? Yeah, it is. But it's all good, man. Yeah, and that's also why I document things that I do, is to show people that from where I came from, with what I have, with what I'm dealing with, that nothing can't be done. If you want it. And if you, exactly, Maria, you, go watch some of my lives. Go watch the live from this afternoon. I love what I do. You can copy, like I said earlier, here's my thing. I said earlier, somebody said, don't give out your secrets and your recipes to do this. There's recipes. People follow them. People release them. Do things. But one thing, you can copy a recipe. You can perfect it or whatever. But one thing you can't copy is somebody that has passion, integrity, and loves what they do. Sometimes you can't mimic that. So if you don't put the love and the passion into the food, that recipe ain't nothing but just food on the table. Jose says, I love Indica Couch. You know, Indica, Indica Couch. I think you're a great soul. I appreciate it, Lucas. That's right, Hamza. Here we go. See, I'll have to go listen to music to put myself to sleep. So, see, I can't be. And Facebook for a start. Yeah, I need 10,000 likes, 10,000 followers. Yeah, that's because you're a first-time viewer. I only did that to maybe sucker you into coming back the next time and giving me that view and click. No, I'm just joking. That was just one of those smooth operator. Got you hooked. Now you can't stop watching. Oh, this guy right here. I can't wait. We're gonna put this in the video too. Matt, I got mine from Weber Restaurant, to be honest with you. I have one, Lucas, but I really don't know much about it. I signed up for it just to claim my name. You know what I mean? I just signed up to claim my name. Like TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, any social media place, I just go and I claim my name. But we're going to be singing this song here pretty soon. Watch this. We're going to be singing this song right here pretty soon. I don't have to, Hamza. I got a screenshot. Trust me, I got a screenshot. Uh-oh. Kyle! Hey, refrigeration dude! My girl at Kraft Bakery needs to get a hold of you. Kyle. Chef Jordan at the bakery needs a refrigeration like 911 3 days ago. I tried to put up a post and tag you in it. But we going to Miami in the food truck. Asian, Spanish, Asian, Indian, Jamaican. Black, white, Cuban, and Asian. Santana's a jam. I cook good, they say. People tell me, put up a restaurant. I love cooking, but not that much to do it for a living. I hear, yeah, hey Maria, sometimes that's what it is. Sometimes it's a passion just to do for yourself. And it's not just doing for yourself, it's just you're a good cook. You know, being in this industry or in the restaurant industry isn't for everybody. Believe me, we're all misfits. Believe it. We're misfits of all types. See, Lucas, I don't know anything about all of that stuff. You know what I'm saying? I don't follow. See, that's, I'm busy working. I don't have time to go and follow pages and do things. And are you going to be in Daytona or Port Orange? We are. I am Victoria. I'm either like Daytona or Orlando. Yes, ma'am. John says, 23 years in the business. I know this to be true. We're misfits. Oh. Delete that comment. Kyle. I'm going to send you Jordan's number. Oh, I love what I'm doing. I love it. I love getting my ass kicked while I'm cooking. I love cursing like a son of a bitch while I'm cooking. I love being in the, under the pressure. I love being in the weeds. You know, it's a therapy for me. I love cooking. But we going to Miami. I'm not in North Carolina, Scott. I'm in Pensacola, Florida. I do, Maria, I do go live. I go live every single day that I work from 11 to 2. I live stream my truck every single day, whether it's good or bad. I live stream it every day. Part of the process, that's it. I'm everything in the truck. I'm head chef, sous chef, fry, cold set, expo, customer service, dishwasher, grocery getter, truck driver, social media, public relations, anxiety. I didn't see it. Hold on, what did that say? Victoria, can drive to Orlando. Please come to Daytona. We are starting our own backyard barbecue, and I know my boyfriend Josh Williams would love to get some pointers, and we both will want to taste your food. I'm trying to get to Daytona. Repairman, there you go, Ellen. Repairman. Engineer. And then redneck engineer. Mechanic. Yeah, engineer. I made my own burger dome. We made my own jacket. You know, that's where I'm going to get my money from. You guys mark my word. You're going to see my jacket on the market. My chef's coat. My. I'm going to try that, Lucas. I'll see. I'll take some rosemary and I'll cut it up and I'll put it on some fries. I'm not a big rosemary guy. Plumber, yeah. Hopefully I ain't got to do any of that. Tire pressure. Yep, I even got a list for that. I got a, these are parts that I got to get for the road trip. Top and lower radiator hose, alternator belt, spare tire, make sure we have oil, tranny fluid, coolant, brake fluid, power fluid, and I already got tools. But that stuff I already have all the time on my truck. Yeah, I'm not a big rosemary guy though. I don't know why. I will try it though. Mark, I gotta figure it out, bro. Electrician, yeah, I wired this. I gotta figure it out, Mark. Dude, there's so many styles of chef coats and shirts and stuff. You know, I like the one that's real thin. That's how it is. Begin. Hopefully one day you can have a whole bunch of trucks. Sorry, didn't know how to word it, but seeing you sit. But sending you. I appreciate it, Miss Maria. I appreciate it. Cinco de Mayo. Hey! Yes, it is Cinco de Mayo. I don't do a Mexican menu. But did you guys know that? Never mind, we're not going to get into that. Oh, that's awesome, Victoria. He made all his own stuff, too. I mean, I'll taste it. I'll eat it if it's got it on it. But it's not something, you know, that... That I like to personally eat all the time. Metalwork specialist. I'm not a specialist. That we're going to have to go ahead and call it a halt. We'll just say we have a specialty ideas. But, yeah, why are we getting jiggy with it? That wasn't the right song. I'm not going down there to get jiggy with it. I'm going down there to earn my name. Sign hanger. I'm everything. Choreographer. Because this is what maybe I can get other food truckers to do one day. Here you go. Maybe I can dance. Hey, hold on. I was waiting for somebody to say that, Aaron. Here, I'm starting a trend. This is it right here. We're starting the food truck train. We'll be right back. We're going to get other food truckers to hop on the train and do a food truck series. What's my personal favorite thing to cook? To be honest, bacon wrap with apple in it, pork chops on the grill, with grilled asparagus, baked potato, ear of corn, and that's my meal. High school days, choo-choo. I'm a lot older than that. I was in prison there. But I got to think of some songs to put in my documentary, too. Yes, I love pork chops with cranberry sauce. Yes, sir. I got to think of some songs to go in my video, so I even have to reach out to people to try. I got a question for you. Are you started this business? That's your dream to have a food truck? Carlos, I started in a 6. I started in a 5x11.5 trailer, doing other things first. James, sis, hold on. I gotta write that down. Man, see. This is what it's like. Watch. See, I got all these notes. Charlie. Carmela. Fort Lauderdale. I love lasagna, too. Choreographer. There we go. I'm choreographer. Fort Lauderdale. Here we go. We're gonna put this song out to another food trucker. How about that? Huh? Cause I know you're watching me. You holler when you speak for me, but you don't know. You say all the hating in the private paper, you don't know. You quit telling people you my father, listen, you don't know. Don't be a goofy, keep it moving, shouting, you don't know. Hey, I ain't tripping, tell the truth, it's really, you don't know. Yeah, I used to work for a few big restaurants. I'm actually coming up with lyrics. Watch. Hold on. There's this guy that I follow. Or not follow. I listen to his music. He's called Big B. There's a song called White Trash Renegade. I'm trying to come up with the lyrics. Food Truck Renegade. Huh? Maria says, where am I originally from? California. See, I need a food truck renegade. Oh, let's play a game of follow the leader. Yeah. that's your new normal. I'm living my life. My new normal in my food truck, I just adapted. I leave sauces and stuff inside. But other than that, I'm living my life and washing my hands 500 more times. I don't live my life in fear. I do take my precautions to protect myself and my family, but I'm not living in fear. I'm doing everything that I do on a daily basis. Get up, go to work, do what I gotta do, and that's it. I ain't changing nothing. I'm not living in fear. When that man upstairs calls my name, he calls my name. Come to Ireland, I'll be that Nate Diaz. You know what Nate Diaz did to that Irishman called Conor McGregor, right? We knocked him out. No. We love Ireland. We love everybody across the pond. Carlos wants to know. Yeah, we can do a question and answer. Do I have a wife and kids? Yes, I have 2 kids. I've been happily married this month, 13 years. May 23rd is our anniversary. Here you go, Maria. Where are you from? We're going to go to the West Coast. Y'all won't know nothing about this song. This actually, do you stand behind the Cuban sandwich? I've never made a Cuban, so I don't know, but I like it. I know I will be going down to Miami to get me a real Cuban from somewhere. You probably won't know who this is, but I like Latin music too. Depending on where you're from. You're 64. Just had heart surgery. Oh, gosh. Well, I am so sorry that you just had heart surgery. Well, I'm glad you're still alive. North Carolina? Oh, yeah, then you won't know this music. We're going back to the Cholo days in California. See, you know, here's how I relate to this song. It's called Let's Jam Latin Active. I go like this, let's jam that fresh food. My mind is always running things like that. So I put my own lyrics to the beats of the song and I like it better. I cook food. I'm from the Bronx, we're strong, there it is. I know, I need a theme song. It's a food truck renegade. I'm telling you. I know that song says white trash renegade, but if I was a lyrical person, I could make that say food truck renegade. I've met Nate Diaz. I met Nate Diaz. That's a cool dude. I like all kinds of music. Depends on what I'm in the mood for. Think I could deliver popcorn to Seattle? Oh, if I could. Yeah, I do need a theme song. I do need a theme song. Gino says they don't know nothing about this music. I just listen to it all, man. It's not really always the... You gotta like the beat. Let's jam Latin Active. Let's jam Latin Active. Let's jam. I'm gonna be cooking some Carlos Saturday. Carlos, I'm gonna be cooking some Saturday. I'll have my machine fixed by that. Michael said, write James a song, you high. He said, you high, write him a song. Rosemary and Fries. Move from the Bronx. Get my boys. See, that's good. That's why I moved out of California. That's why I left California. The day I got out of Folsom State Prison, February 4th of the year 2000, I left Folsom State Prison. My ass hightailed it out of California because I knew I wouldn't be able to live the life that I'm living now if I stayed in California. I would be back in jail for murder. I would be, this is for the La Raza. This is back to the Cholo days, ese. Cubo. I like the beat. And see, the reason I also like this, because I don't know. I just like different shit. See, I know a lot about the Spanish culture because I was locked up with gangbangers. Say nada. You call us what you will. Aztec warriors, that's something to kill. It's my brother being Aztec warrior. Go to any extreme, the whole world ready. It's Chicano. Brown and proud. Get down. Right now, in the dirt. What's the matter? Get hurt? Oh, shit. I need to listen to something slow to go to bed. This is for La Raza. Yeah, I like sweet potato fries. Oh, this is who I'm. Maybe we can get him to meet me. Don't he live down there? Hey, does anybody have this guy's connection? Hold on. This guy lives down there. Hold on. He lives down there. Let's see if we can get this guy. Used to live in L.A.? I lived in L.A. Believe me, I know a lot of... I was in Folsom State Prison when they filmed American Me. I was in San Quentin when they filmed Blood In and Blood Out. Cletus McFarlane. Maybe we can get this guy to come to my food truck. Maybe he could bring this gang with him. But that's a part of my past life, you know. But actually, that's kind of what made me mold me today to stay out. So, now that I got all these notes and everything that I got, we got 5,000 notes. I can't sleep. My anxiety's to the freaking roof tonight. So, we're going to see if we can meet Cisco. Anybody know Cisco? See if you can give him an invite to the food truck. Oh, my wife is home. She's probably going to come in here. You love oldies? Oh. My wife is home. She's out there. I can hear her. oldies. Here's an oldie. Watch this one. It's time to go, but here, we'll leave you this one. This is a real oldie. No, I don't do pills. Cletus does have a huge following. No, my wife, she won't get on camera. She don't like it. Here you go. That song tattooed on me. Anyways, I'm out of here. I'm gonna go put my notes to bed. Go get cussed out by the wife. You're on Facebook. What are you doing? You should be asleep. Can't sleep.